Hi everyone, welcome to our channel BA Civil Engineer. Today in this video we are going to learn about settlement of soils. So earlier in the videos we have discussed about compaction and consolidation. So compaction, after doing compaction or after doing consolidation, the effect of that compaction or consolidation on the soil is generally referred as settlement. So coming to the definition of settlement in soil, it is simply the vertical component of displacement of soil and superimposed loads. So when the soil is subjected to superimposed loads, it is undergoing some rearrangement or it is undergoing some reduction in volume. That particular vertical component of that reduction in volume taking place or displacement taking place in the volume of the soil is generally referred as settlement of soil. So if you see here, when the load is acting on the soil, so because of the superimposed load which was acting on the soil, there is some amount of displacement in the soil. So that particular displacement, that amount of displacement which is generally referred as delta, so that amount of displacement which is taking place in the soil is generally referred as settlement in soil. So this settlement, the amount of settlement, how much amount of settlement is taking place in the soil. So if you observe this amount of settlement, if the amount of settlement is more and more, if it is increasing, then the permissible limits, then it may lead to destruction of the structure or destruction of structure or failure of structure, and the suitability of the structure for occupancy or the functionality of the structure will also be get reduced, or it is going to get damaged because of this increase in amount of settlements which is going to take place below the settlement taking place because of the superimposed loads. If you see the amount of settlement which is taking place because of the superimposed load in a soil base is considered as S, or it is referred as S. So the total settlement taking place after completion of a settlement process is referred as S, which is a sum of SI plus SC plus SS. So SI is the immediate settlement, SC is the primary consolidation settlement, and SS is the secondary consolidation settlement. So the total amount of settlement that is taking place in the soil due to superimposed loads is the combination of these three types of settlement. So coming to immediate settlement, it is the amount of settlement taking place simultaneously with application of a load or with application of superimposed load on the soil. So on application of load, immediately with the effect of load, there is some amount of settlement in the soil. That particular amount of soil settlement is referred as a SI or a immediate settlement. So when we are applying load, instantly it is going to take place because of that application of load or because of that superimposed load acting on that. Instantaneously there is some reduction in volume. That particular reduction in volume is referred as the immediate settlement. During the immediate settlement, during the process of immediate settlement, there is some amount of expulsion of air voids, expulsion of air from the voids is going to take place because of this sudden impact of the superimposed loads, and that leads to reduction in volume. That is what we refer as a immediate settlements. So here it is very clear that expulsion of air is, we all know, is nothing but a compaction. So we can understand that during the immediate settlement, this compaction process is going to get initiated in the soil. So coming to primary consolidation settlement. In the primary consolidation settlement process, when the load is furthermore applied on the soil, it leads to expulsion. It starts expulsion of pore water pressure. Expulsion of pore water from voids is taking place, which is generally referred as consolidation process. So after starting this consolidation process, with respect to time, it is going to take place. As the time goes on, the water, amount of water is going to get expelled out. More amount of water is going to get expelled out. So on expulsion of pore water pressure from the soil, it leads to reduction of soil volume, which is referred as primary consolidation settlement. So in this way, the soil is going to get subjected to reduction in volume because of the immediate load, that is a superimposed load, that is what we refer as immediate settlement, and later on due to expulsion of pore water pressure as a primary consolidation settlement, and after completion of 100% consolidation due to rearrangement because of the effective stress acting on the soil particles, constant effective stress acting on the soil particles, as the secondary consolidation settlement is going to take place in the soil, all that together we refer it as a total settlement in soil.